The girl in the car window opposite me, she keeps on staring at me. Does she love me? How will I know? Will I ever know? The girl in the car window opposite me, she keeps on looking at me.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to this week's video. In this week's video, I'm excited to share a new tutorial with you guys because I love doing tutorials and I have a fun one that works perfectly for Mother's Day. So it's already Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. So this can work for a great birthday gift or just random little special gift or for yourself or something like that. So this week's tutorial is how to DIY paint a tote bag. And so I did this actually in my costume design class. We can make whatever we want. And so back here, you can see it back there. I made a cute little tote bag and it was just like, I just started with canvas and then I used a pattern and I sewed it all together. And then I wanted to paint on it. So I wanted to like paint or embroider something fun on it. So I painted this in class and I really liked how it turned out. And so for Mother's Day, my mom was like, well, we have these two tote bags that I bought a while ago because they were on sale or something, and so it would work if you wanted to paint them for my Nana and my grandma for Mother's Day. So it worked out perfectly that we had those so I can make a tutorial. So for this, it's a pretty easy tutorial. You just need to buy a tote bag or make a tote bag if you have a pattern. So any canvas tote bag or anything like that would work. So for supplies, you will need a tote bag, acrylic paint, a clothing iron, a little bit of tin foil, and paint brushes and everything like that. And stampers or anything else you want to use to decorate the paint. And before you start painting, if you want, if your bag is wrinkled, it may be useful to iron out your bag or whatever you're painting on to make sure that there aren't any wrinkles, and so when you're painting, you don't solidify any wrinkles. So first what you want to do is tape off the area where you're going to be painting if you want to paint a background. So for all of the bags I've done, I painted a solid color background first. So for the one that I made, I did a white background to paint on, so it was kind of like a canvas on the bag. And for the other ones, I did colored backgrounds, and I didn't tape it off on the ones I did for my grandparents because there was already kind of a border around there, so I didn't need to tape it off. But I would suggest doing that so that the lines are really clean and it doesn't bleed anywhere. And then what you want to do is just paint the background, and I did two coats on all the bags that I did, and that was enough. You don't want to do too many coats or make the paint too thick, or else it'll crack easier and peel and stuff like that, so you don't want that to happen. So you want to paint the background a solid color if you're going to do that, and then to paint your design on the top, just take thin brushes or whatever brush works for you and paint whatever design you want. And you can use paint markers or stamps or something like that, and whatever else you're going to use to decorate, and just decorate the front. I'd suggest finding a design on Pinterest or a quote or something you're going to base it off of, so you know where you're going and you know kind of what it's going to look like. And that's what I did for all of mine, is I found a quote or a picture on Pinterest of what I wanted to do and I based it off of that. So you want to paint the details and paint and draw and do everything like that and erase your pencil marks and everything to decorate the bag. And then once you're done decorating, like completely done painting and drawing and everything like that on the bag, then you want to take an iron and put it on a pretty like low to medium setting. Take an iron and the tin foil, and this sounds really weird, but trust me, it'll make sense. Put the tin foil down on the paint, iron on the tin foil where the paint is. And so the tin foil kind of acts as like a sealer, sort of, if that makes sense. So by using the heat on the tin foil, it kind of glues the paint into place so it won't crack or chip or anything like that. So you have to do this part to make sure that the bag doesn't chip or anything. And this bag and the other bags, for as long as I've had them, they haven't cracked or chipped or anything, so as long as you're not too rough with them, they should be fine and hold up pretty well with the decorations. So as soon as you're done ironing, there you have it. You have your bag, and I hope it turned out really well. This is a really fun and simple tutorial, and I love tote bags. I think they're great. I use them for school all the time, and I'm sure that my grandparents will enjoy it. And here's some footage of me giving the bags to my Nana and Grandma today for Mother's Day.
You can't go with us. Dogs aren't allowed on the school bus. Woof.
So there you have it. It's a pretty simple tutorial, but very fun and very useful. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye. She's a Mona Lisa.
Everyone's lining up to see her.